Tell us about this. How come you were forced to leave? Now it sounds kind of funny now, but in those days it was pretty grim. Tell us those circumstances, John, because that should be recorded for posterity, as we say.
Go ahead a little bit further on the mic and see where you're at. Okay, I don't exactly give what you told me.
Well, you remember you told me that somebody came over and told you that they were after you.
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about.
I was in the river shelling, and I heard my mother call, "Hey, John." And I noticed it was her voice, and she was, where she called it, I thought that my kids or something had happened to them. So as fast as I could row the boat to where she was, I went there, and she said, "John, say you better get away from here. Say this white fella, he was standing there with her." She called him and said he was up at the store, and they say they got the rope and limb. All they want is you get away from here.
They got the rope and limb, and all they need is John Handcox.
Yeah, so I said, "Mama ain't going nowhere. I'm going to shoot it out." She said, "Oh, no, John, don't do that. Say if you just hurt one of them, they'll kill us all." And she was right after I thought about it, but, you know, just being in a moment of truth. You just like people do something in a moment. You know, if you'd had just a little time or somebody would have stopped you, you wouldn't do that. So that's the way it was. But I left and I went to Memphis and then
I continued. Did you leave right away then?
I left that evening after.
You didn't waste any time.
I didn't waste no time.
Were they after you because you had developed a reputation of organizing?
Yeah, because I was organizing union. They said if they could stop that John Handcox, that they thought they could stop the union. Yeah, that was their purpose of wanting to get.
Well, what year was that back in John?
What year?
Yeah, what are we talking about now? Was that 37 or something?
No, that was in 35.
Oh, yeah? Mm-hmm.
No, that was in 36. It was in 36.
So how did you get out then? You went to Memphis and
went
to the union office or what?
I walked about 4 or 5 miles to a fellow's house, a friend of a house that I knew lived on the highway. And the Greyhound bus was passing his house. It was easy. I only had a 2-lane road then, one wide enough for the pass, you know. And it was a rock road. It wasn't paved. It's just a rock road. And I went over and spent the night with him, and then I caught the bus on into Memphis and went out to the Southern Tenant Farmers Union headquarters, and then they made arrangement for me to stay in Memphis for while I wrote the song, wrote about Frank Weems in Memphis. The song about Frank Weems. That's
thought
a song.
Was kidnapped and they thought was... Can you give us a little bit? They thought he was killed, is that right?
Well, all I can, I wasn't at the... I wasn't present when it all happened, is what I mean to say. I can give you what Frank Weems told me. I was the first to see Frank Weems after this was over of the union. I met him in Chicago at the... can't even call the name of that now. It's an organization they had there for sending out workers and stuff like that. It helped you to get jobs. It wasn't a job agency, but it was
something like it. But anyway, you wrote the song, I imagine, based on his telling you what happened. Was that it?
No, song I wrote, I wrote it in Memphis. It was a few days after the word got out that Frank Weems had got killed or something.
Yeah.
I wrote that song.
Do you recall that song, John, to do a little bit of that? I don't know.
No, not enough. I haven't sang that song very often. I can't hardly read.
That's not one of the popular for me.
No. It went like this though. I want somebody to tell me and tell me right. I want somebody to tell me where Frank Weems tonight.
Oh, that was because he was kidnapped and disappeared.
Yeah.
And was
dead. Well, they beat him up and left him laying in a ditch. They thought he was dead.
Yeah.
Him and Jim Reese. Say, Jim Reese was a white fellow.
Was Weems a black fellow?
Weems was black.
Uh-huh.
But him and Reese was together marching when these...
They grabbed him?
When these planters, bosses, the stooges and things that would contact them and sheriffs. They had sheriffs and laws and police and things was out there to break up this strike. See, that was... We were supposed to be in striking for... I think it's $1 a day, we was asking for day labor, you know.
Dollar a day.
Of course, we didn't work hours.
Yeah, you worked for about a day. Did you work sun up to sunset or something?
That's about the way it went from sun up to sundown, from the time you can see till you can't see.
Is that how they call it? Is that how they say it? From can to can't. You can see to the time you can't see. That's a good round way. That's 12-14 hours.
Yeah, some of them run more hours than that. In the long days, in the midsummer.
It seemed like Memphis was a place where everybody would escape to when things got too hot in Arkansas. But was it hot in Memphis too? Why didn't you just stay in Memphis?
Well, no, the office was once over in Arkansas. The main office was in Arkansas, and I think it was actually they had to move on, kind of disturbing. I won't just pinpoint that but after they went to throwing them people's things, see, they hauled the people's. Find out they belong to the union, and they just get that little hay mattress and whatever they had and carried out and throw it on the side of the highway. And,
Were they moved out of their houses?
Yeah, they moved them out of their houses. You know, the houses was owned by the companies, you know, but they moved them out of those houses and just grabbed the stuff and them and get them out there and throw them all up on the highway. Well, Norman Thomas and a bunch of them, I was told, that got some tents. They had a tent section set up alongside the highway for some time. And they made some kind of deal down in Hill House, Mississippi. And they moved the peoples off of the road down the Hills House, Mississippi, and they formed what was known as the cooperative farming down there. They had white and black that was evicted and thrown off on the highway down there. I went down there. I spent a week down there after I had to leave Arkansas on account of the strike, Mitchell. And asked me, would I like to go down there?